Hello everyone, welcome to College on Your Thoughts on Education Initiative, through which we aim to better communicate vision of colleges to prospecting students and parents. Today we have with us Dr. Srinivas Murthy. He is currently a professor of finance and dean at IPE. He is also the head of placements division. He holds a master's degree in commerce from Sri Venkateswara University, a master's degree in international business from Pondicherry University, and a doctorate degree from University of Madras. He's a recipient of UGC Junior Research Fellowship for the doctorate program. He has around 2 decades of experience in teaching, research, training, and consultancy. He is a visiting faculty to IIM Kozhikode, IIM Indore, NIT Warangal, IIIF, JNTU, Acharya NG Ranga Agriculture University, and many other universities. He has done consultancy assignments for World Bank, ADB, Ministry of Rural Development, Government of India, and many state-level enterprises. Welcome, sir.
Thank you.
So you have held key positions at education institutions throughout your professional career. What are the key factors that keep you connected with the education sector?
Thank you, Likhit Sai Verma, for this opportunity. And also I'm happy to meet the prospective students, the many students who are planning to do a course in management as well. For myself, I have worked in a single institution with multiple responsibilities. My experience, I joined in the institute in 1994. And from then onwards, I have got experience. So I was doing, I was coordinating a part-time MBA program. Besides teaching, I was coordinating a part-time MBA program, which is affiliated to Usmania University. It is a program where students with 3 years experience, they can join the course. Then I have coordinated a full-time a PGDM program, taking care of all aspects of then I floated one program, actually designed and floated program called as PGDM Banking, Insurance and Financial Services. In 2008, I was the first program coordinator for that. And that is having intake of 120 now. That program is doing very well. Then I also worked as controller of examinations for the entire institute, looking into the evaluation aspects and all these things. So over a period of 2.5 decades, I've been with the institution. And after completing the control examinations, I've also done as the deputy dean and head of placements. I also looked after the placements in the institute, and we have improved the placement scenario in terms of packages and number of companies coming to the campus, number of profiles for which the companies were coming. So there is a clear increase in the direction of placement after I took over. Then after that, I've been appointed as dean for the institute. And now I am the chairman placement and dean. I am in charge of the entire campus here. Academic activities, we have 1,080 students on campus, 540 first year and 542nd year students. And full of activities, of course, now because of the pandemic, we don't have students on campus. Otherwise, we have been having students here, and of course we are continuing with online classes. We are continuing, so we have that experience of running different responsibilities since my joining IPE in 1994, and that actually keeps me closely connected with the education sector and the development that are taking place in the education sector.
Sir, being the dean at IPE, what is your philosophy of leadership? How do you describe your leadership style?
See, as I have been working, what I really realize is that my philosophy of leadership is work hard with vision, integrity, and humility. My leadership style is to work with fellow colleagues with empathy, understanding, and cooperation. So it is like, you know, we have to work together and create opportunities for others, encourage others, other colleagues and fellow beings, and motivate them to work towards the common goal. So it is a leadership position is more of a complementary and more of a cooperation now. So we have to work together with people and try to achieve the common goal.
Sir, how do you strategize for key programs and plans for marketing and administration of the college?
Yeah, when you think of strategizing a program, new programs and the things, normally we keep into consideration all our important stakeholders. Very important, whatever we do, we keep our stakeholders. Our stakeholders include, of course, our students, our faculty, our alumni, and our recruiters, government, regulator, and society at large. So we keep all these stakeholders in mind, and we involve them right from the beginning. So in the academic cycle, what we are talking as, it starts with, say, curriculum development. So we have a board of studies for every program, long-term program. So there we have nominees of recruiters, alumni, students. So we make them part of the curriculum development itself so that they know what is expected by the industry. Now that way, we see that we are reducing the gap between what we deliver and what the industry expects. And after commencement, after completing the curriculum development, after the commencement of the academic activities, we try to involve them in all possible ways. We invite them as guest faculty. We give them full courses to teach in the institute. And also, we keep them as part of our other important roles. For example, we have various committees are there in the institute, academic committees are there. So there also we involve the alumni. And we bring them to the campus on a regular basis to create, to have better industry academic interface. So students, they have an opportunity of interacting with these people when they come to give guest lectures. And we also take our students to the industry in the form of industrial visits. And we also provide them 2 months summer internship. So they are attached with the industry, they work with the industry. So they get to know what is expected of them in the industry. And not only that, we involve them to talk to the students about the company. So they come and talk about what are the expectations of the company, replacement talks and everything we arrange so that the students will come to know their dream company by listening to these companies and their and we are providing all possible amenities to our students so that you know they perform very well in their real life. And even coming to the certificate, we ensure that it has true value and value addition by providing whatever is expected. So the pedagogy we follow basically involves lectures and case studies, computer-based exercises, Excel-based exercises, I mean, and we have book review exercises, article review presentations, all these things, including simulation, management games, etc. The pedagogy is designed in such a way that the students, though they are non-commerce students or non-management students, but they get very good access to the subjects because though they are coming from, say, engineering or sciences background, we find them taking finance as an elective. We find them taking marketing as an elective and they emerge as the experts in that area. Now, all these possible mainly because of the curriculum we provide and also the delivery, classroom delivery, which is has the rigor and also we have the pedagogy, which actually ensures that students, they understand. Even the evaluation system also tries to test their knowledge, whether it is internal evaluation and interim evaluation, that is kept in mind. And it ensures that they have that sufficient knowledge. Because based on this only, they are going to crack the interviews. In fact, we incorporate important components like personal development, business communications, business aptitude in the curriculum itself, so that they are trained very well to placement, to the placement scenario. That's how we are able to get very good placements as well.
Sir, the education systems in India and other foreign countries are structured very differently. In your experience, what can an inbound student gain from studying here in IPE?
Yeah, IPE is a place where we believe in research-based education. So we conduct research conferences, we share the research output with the students, and they have that feel of research in whatever they do. And the various seminars, research seminars we organize, will give them the sufficient fillip with regard to the development that are taking place in this arena. And we always believe that they should have the global mindset, and we train them by discussing about the case studies. And we train the students in the emerging areas, and our curriculum will ensure that they learn at least one foreign language, and they also have understanding about the global culture and what are the developments that are taking place across countries with regard to a particular discipline. When you talk about a particular function, we talk in terms of how it is practiced in other countries as well. So that way, they have complete understanding about the management discipline and the various opportunities they can expect by doing an MBA course in an institution like IP. So we take care of the complete overall personality development of the individual. So we believe in that. They should have strong conceptual base, which we provide in the classroom. And they should have strong communication skills. We ensure that through their presentations in the classrooms and also having an exclusive course on communications and personality development. And we also ensure that they should have the basic problem solving skills. And they are also trained in business aptitude and session, so that they are able to crack, you know, various tests conducted by the recruiters. And that whatever case studies we discuss, it will help them in understanding similar situations in other countries. That is how we say that they are emerging as global leaders.
So what do you believe are your roles and responsibilities towards the institution and the students?
With regard to my position as dean, so there is a dual role again. One is, of course, looking at the faculty. So I have to ensure that the faculty have the ample opportunities for the growth and academic development. So we ensure that they are trained in these areas. They are also sent to faculty development programs. So they are encouraged to present papers and research conferences. And they are also encouraged to go abroad. And they are also provided with incentives whenever they publish articles in ABCD category, ABDC category journals. And that actually motivates them to write more articles, research articles and like that. So when it comes to the students, we always believe that they should get the best. They are our real customers. So we take care of their academic requirements, curriculum requirements, and we provide them opportunities so that they can have rich campus life. And excellent hostel facilities are provided at Shambirpet campus, IP campus, with AC accommodation and single occupancy, double occupancy rooms available. Various sports facilities are available. Football court, tennis courts, and badminton, table tennis, basketball. No, lot of gym, every facility is available. And students are encouraged to form different groups. Groups in the sense, no? Like student groups, they themselves run the groups, like a marketing club. We call them as clubs, groups. Marketing club, finance club, operation club, HR club, photography club, social club, book reading club. So all these clubs will provide them opportunities to ventilate their ideas, to discuss freely their ideas and shed their inhibitions, if any. And they improve communications very well. And that is very important. The studies have shown that the students who are very active in campus life, they will be active in corporate life as well. The basic foundation is laid in the management school, B school like IP. So it's not only the knowledge and the skill, communication skills, writing skills, email writing skills, networking skills. So all these things are provided as in a capsule form. So they are ready to take up any responsibility. This is my role.
So can you talk about the impact COVID-19 pandemic has had on curriculum, the students and the faculty? What are the new steps that you're taking to make learning more inclusive?
Yeah, in fact, pandemic has thrown a lot of challenges to many educational institutions. IP is no exception. The moment we got the notifications from the government that we have to close down the institutions, so we made all arrangements for students to leave to their native places, providing them transport facilities, and also financial support if it's required, because they should reach safely. So we were in touch with parents to find out whether they have reached safely or not. Then quickly we moved to the online education with the faculty through Microsoft Teams. They started teaching, and there is a scope for interaction with the students. Not only the teaching, evaluation also we have done online, internal and continuous assessment, and finally interim examination through MeritTrack. So we outsourced the service. So the proctored way of examinations we have conducted to the satisfaction. And so that way, in a seamless fashion, we have continued what we used to do in the normal course of time in the offline mode. The same thing we are able to do in the online mode, because we are able to adapt very quickly, invest money in the required infrastructure, whether it is classroom infrastructure or online classroom delivery, or even online examinations. So suitable infrastructure has been created so that the students will have the same experience. Now, whatever club activities I was telling, student clubs, the students were able to continue in online mode. So they used to have online, farewell, online welcome, or juniors, so online seminars, online club activities. So that has become the order of the day. So we have to adapt ourselves and see that how best we can deliver value to our students. So in the pandemic situation, IP has actually reacted so fast and aptly, so that students are very happy. In fact, we had a blended, because the government actually asked us to open institutions for a while, 45 days. But then government said, you please give the option to the students. The students can choose offline or online. So we have given that option. So we have opened the hostels. So students who were here, they were given classroom with social distancing. We have provided the classroom teaching to them. Same lecture is listened to by the students from their homes through this online mode, Microsoft Teams. So the blended mode of teaching has been successfully implemented by IP.
So we would like to know more about your vision for IP. What do you think is IP's top priority for the next 10 years?
Yeah. So IP, is, as you have seen, in 1995, you started the long-term education programs, 1995, first batch. So we started with intake of, say, 50 students. But over a period of time, looking at the demand in the industry, the need for trained graduates, we have started a variety of programs. There was a boom in the retail sector. We started PGDM retail marketing in 2007 with intake of 60. There was a financial meltdown. Banking sector was going through a turmoil, right? At that time, there was a need for skilled banking personnel. So we started a PGDM banking, insurance and finance services in 2008. 2009, we started PGDM international business. And 2012, we started PGDM HR and executive PGDM. Now in all these programs, though we started with intake of 50, but now PGDM, we have intake of 240. Banking, we started with 60, we have intake of 120. Remaining programs, we have intake of 60 each. That means we have grown from 60 to 540, 50 to 540. So we have been looking at what is happening in the industry, what are the requirements of the industry. Accordingly, we have been designing new programs. In the years to come, we plan to start new programs, especially in the area of business analytics, supply chain management, right? The areas where there is a requirement of trained graduates. So we are planning to start new programs, two-year programs, online certificate courses, and MOOCs courses. We are encouraging students to have extra certifications. We have Bloomberg Terminal with us. So we are encouraging our students. We have BM certification of Bloomberg Terminal. Then we have SAP available. So we are encouraging students to go for SAP certification. Like that, in the years to come, we'd like to provide more and more opportunities for students for extra certifications, and for students also to join new courses, emerging technologies. So we have already made changes in the curriculum, and we have introduced artificial intelligence, machine learning, Internet of Things in the curriculum, and we are providing exclusive elective in business analytics now. In addition to traditional analytics like marketing, HR, operation system, HR and systems, we are offering business analytics, economics, entrepreneurship. So IP is one of the few institutions we are having electives in business analytics and entrepreneurship. So that way, we are not only providing electives, within each elective, we are providing wide choice. For example, a student who has taken finance and marketing. In finance itself, there will be 15 subjects, out of which he is choose any four. Similarly, marketing, about 15 subjects, he can choose any four of his liking. So wide choice is provided. That way, we are able to provide almost 120 elective subjects to the students. So this journey is continuous. So we continuously update the curriculum through Board of Studies meetings, where we involve our recruiters, alumni, students, and academicians, and continuously we revise the curriculum. And wherever necessary, we introduce them. Even during the course also, we conduct one-day seminars where we think that, okay, every recent development, we can get the knowledge to the students through, say, one-day workshop or a half-day workshop. So that's how we are very keen on providing continuous improvement in whatever we do. I would like to provide the best to the students who are our customers.
So what would you like people to know about IP that they may not know now?
Yeah. So people might have seen the website faculty, but what I suggest to the people is that first of all, they should see the institution physically, or at least virtual tour of IP, which we have provided in the website. So we have many things here we do. As I have been telling, our faculty, they not only teach, they do research, training, and consultancy. Very rarely. These four are the important activities of our faculty. And continuously, they are in interaction with industry people in solving their problems. So they bring whatever case studies, whatever consultancy project they have done, they bring it to the classroom in the form of case studies. That is actually is a very important thing that happens in the classroom. And the faculty, they also involve the students in their consultancy projects, either in data collection or analysis. So that way, you find that the students are benefited a lot by joining here. And a mentoring system we are having. See, for every 10 to 12 students, a faculty is identified as a mentor. Right from the day one, he will take care of the requirements of the student in terms of academic and non-academic aspects. So how he is performing in studies, curricular, extracurricular, co-curricular activities, and where he is strong, so he is encouraged. And where he is weak, he is actually advised to improve, the ways to improve. And parents are also are kept in the loop about the developments of the students. And the mentor will guide them for a summer project, long-term project. So you have single point contact for the student to attend to any other problems. In addition to that, they have access to the course coordinators, dean, registrar, director. So it's like IP is like a family. That's the reason you find it is like a mini Indian IP campus, Shyamripet campus. Students come from different parts of the country and different festivals are celebrated happily by all the students. So you find that cultural, we celebrate Ethnic Day. So Ethnic Day in the institute where the students, they celebrate different cultures. They come in different attires. They have very, rich campus life, I can say. They not only study here, they also get knowledge outside the classroom through interaction with their colleagues, the friends, faculty, guest faculty, industry experts. So this is a continuous process of learning. And there is a joy in learning, actually. That's how we believe that IP is the most happening place in terms of knowledge acquisition and assimilation, and also dissemination of the knowledge by the faculty to the students.
So lastly, what is your advice for the current youth and the aspiring students of IP?
Yeah. My sincere advice to the students is that, first of all, they should have a holistic approach to education. See, when they join a two-year program, they have to concentrate. They have to put in their best of their efforts. It is not the question of getting degree. Industry is expecting that they have already done graduation, maybe engineering or science or BCom. So added to that, in the 2 years, they are further trained in various aspects. So they have to take it very seriously. They have to get very good sound knowledge in fundamentals. Maybe marketing, finance, HR, anything. Strong fundamental knowledge is very, very important. They should work hard. There are no shortcuts to success. They have to work hard. If they work hard for 2 years, they can relax later on. But if they relax during the 2 year period, they have to do hard work later. So we advise the students to do hard work during the campus days, and is a joyful way of learning. So you get maximum knowledge and skills here. And you are ready. Wherever you go, these good habits you have cultivated will help you to further succeed in corporate life as well. So we keep on telling students that hard work, humility is very, very important. Gratitude is also very, very important, right? So we have to keep our culture. We should respect our parents, teachers. It's very, very important. And we should have gratitude to the people who have helped us. And continuously, you should aspire to improve. Every day is a new beginning. You should always compare, am I better today when compared to yesterday? And that is possible only when you listen to the various lectures in the classroom, case studies discussed in the classroom, and various updates provided to them on a day-to-day basis. So they should not think that just because you paid the fees, you will get knowledge. No, it's not like that. A company may come to the campus. We may allow 100 students or 200 students. For example, a marketing company comes to the recruitment. We allow all marketing profile students to sit, but the students who crack the interview are only the sincere students always. These students have, say, 98%, 100% attendance. They are closely following what is happening in the classroom. So they should be very alert in the classroom. So if you are not alert in the classroom, even if you are physically present, there is no use. Not only physically present, mentally you should be present and interact with the faculty and get the best out of the faculty and read extra articles and presentations, whatever we have. They have to listen to them, and they should evaluate themselves. Yes, am I improving or not? So what are the expectations of the industry people, recruiters? And there we are providing additional support to them through extra classes, extra certifications. And through that, they can actually aim high. So they should have that attitude to grow, attitude to learn. So sky is the limit for the people. So their attitude is very important, attitude to learn new things. So their attitude will decide their altitude. So if they have good attitude, they will have good careers as well. This.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for connecting with us and sharing your thoughts and information about IT. I'm sure this is extremely helpful to prospecting students. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Likhit and College Duniya, for giving this opportunity of meeting many students. Okay. I wish all the students all the best in their careers. And we wish our College Duniya also all the best. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.